Recently, an ordinary woman named Brittany Provo in Oklahoma, USA, was convicted of third-degree manslaughter by the court because of a miscarriage. The women's rights organization looked down on it, and past public opinion has made the matter a big deal. In recent years, there have been more and more cases of miscarriage and abortion in the United States against women. Since Oklahoma does not implement anti-abortion laws, these cases are all sued for drug abuse or dangerous behavior. The vast majority of women prosecuted are drug users and ethnic minority low-income groups. However, compared to Texas next door, Oklahoma's situation is not bad. Just last month, Texas passed the anti-abortion law, stipulating that abortion is not allowed at 6 weeks of pregnancy, regardless of the reason for pregnancy. This means that almost all abortions are banned because many people will not know that they are pregnant at 6 weeks of pregnancy. That is, when the menstrual period is delayed by 2 weeks. It is also very unfair to those who are hurt and become pregnant. Most importantly, this bill affects not only women in Texas. It deeply exposes the loopholes in the legal system of the separation of powers in the United States. Because of the inequality of the three powers in the United States, the power of judicial review is very limited. As long as Congress passes, even if it is unreasonable, the Supreme Court cannot repeal a bill, and the whistleblowing decree issued by Texas this time just exploited this loophole. To fix this loophole, only the court and Congress can have the same status. However, in the case of bipartisan disputes in the United States, this is basically impossible. In September last year, one of the 9 justices of the U.S. Supreme Court, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, passed away. Trump seized the last power in his term and promoted conservative Justice Amy Coney Barrett to the position. The score became 6-3, and the Democratic Party suffered even more. Sure enough, in this Texas case, Barrett played a key role and cast a decisive vote, which eventually led to the Texas anti-abortion case taking effect. A butterfly fanning its wings can cause a hurricane in the Pacific Ocean. And some decisions have more far-reaching effects. Since he came to power, Biden has been filling the big hole left by Trump at all times. On the 18th, he also asked the Supreme Court to take urgent action to prevent the anti-abortion law from taking effect. He couldn't think that a year has passed since the election, and the shadow of Trump's division of the United States still looms over him.